roll, Earl.
Hey, boss.
Pull over up here.
Counselor?
Eddie, we had a deal. Either pay me or go with a public defender.
Another $5,000?
$10,000.
Oh. Ain't you gonna count it?
Just did.
These are all fan questions submitted by our users.
Okay.
And I'm just gonna run down a few stats for you before we start. So we had a few thousand questions. Among those was 17 marriage proposals.
Great.
Take that as you want. 25 your sexies.
Great.
Do with that as you will.
Okay.
And there were 7 suggestions for you to take over Charlie Sheen's role in 2 and a Half Men. So how does that make you feel?
Great.
So the first question that we got comes from Sergio, and he asks, he heard that you had actually wanted to be a lawyer in real life. So how did playing this role, and I know you've played lawyers before, but how did playing this character, you know, make you feel about the profession?
Well, when I wanted to become a lawyer in college, I was much more idealistic about what that meant and what lawyers did. Now, 20-some years later, and the work I got to do on this movie, I learned a lot about the system, how it works. The deals that are made, the games that are played, the politics that are involved. It's not as clear-cut as most of us would believe. It's not as clear-cut as I thought it was. It still is a profession that allows someone to do it honorably, but it's just not black and white. There are, like I said, so many deals being cut outside of court. The prisons are full. The courthouses are full. You got to turn these cases over, and very few ever get to the courthouse anyway. And over 90% are plead outside of court before they ever get to a courthouse. So just that the haggling that goes on, and you're dealing with someone's livelihood, is really intriguing.
Hey, Mick, I got something really big for you.
What's the name?
Louis. Louis Roulette.
Louis Roulette?
This whole thing is a setup. I made a mistake with that woman, and she was setting me up.
Down.
I need $100,000 up front.
I'm working on $550 an hour.
I take it none of that's a problem?
No.
I just got lucky.
The charges against my son are ridiculous. So is that woman.
Regina Campo, part-time actress, part-time office temp.
And hoping to retire after suing my client.
According to the victim, she was at home alone when the suspect forced her down.
You didn't strike Miss Campo with your left fist.
No.
Threatened to kill
her. No, I am not that guy.
I don't know, Mick. This kid feels wrong to me. Are you sure there's not anything that you're not telling me?
Nothing.
John wanted to know if you could defend a famous criminal, dead or alive, who would it be and why?
If anyone gets a chance to read, remember Milosevic, Yugoslavia? He defended himself. Really brilliant-minded man. And I got into a habit of reading. I found this place where I was reading what his defense was, printed out. And it was the guy's argument was amazing. And he ended up dying, whether he was murdered or not, whatever. But his wife died and then he did. And he had that court locked up for years. And his defense was mastermindedly done. Anyway, and so that was always on the back page and we kind of forgot about it. But that was a really interesting case that I was like reading this guy's defense going, oh my gosh, he makes a good point. I can't believe he just swung people over like that. And he kept this court. He'd probably still be in court if he was alive. Still defending himself, however many, over a decade later.
And final question,
yeah.
I gotta ask you about your Longhorns, because we're going to March Madness. Who do you think are gonna be their toughest competition?
Right now, it's simple, their toughest competition is them. They got so hot, and they had the mojo, and they had it rolling, and then they lost a little bit when they lost Colorado and Nebraska, and then they went back, got a really good road win against Baylor. You know, keep the defense up. They're such a good defensive team. And then their offense just got a little bit stagnant. But they still have time to find it again, find that rhythm that they had when they probably weren't thinking as much, you know?
Yeah.
And Barnes will have them ready. He always has a mentally tough team. And go out and play that defense to where the other teams really don't want to play against you because you just stifle them.
Yeah.
And at the same time, when your offense, get the flow going again. And if they do that, they can go all the way.
You think you're the first client to ever threaten me or my family?
trying to make it right.